It's Entertainment Schmig.
Okay, let's start with Michael Caine's boyhood home is up for sale.
Michael Caine?
Michael Caine.
Apparently the house where, yeah, I know we were joking about Michael Caine.
And but then you actually had a story about him?
Well, I looked it up.
Oh, okay.
It's like, I wonder if there's anything going on with my cocaine. As a 7-year-old, he lived there when he was better known as Maurice Micklewhite. That's one that you need for a trivia night here in St. Louis.
So, wait, now, hold on a second. Where is it? In Leeds? Or, I mean,
what? It's in Norfolk.
Norfolk.
He lived there after he left bomb-threatened South London with his mom and his brother, Stanley. Stanley Caine. No.
Stanley Micklewhite.
They have an asking price of £400,000. Not so a cheap place.
No. That's about, what, now about $450? Something like that.
Yeah.
$475 American.
Yeah, something like that. But now on to serious news. No. Doris Roberts from Everybody Loves Raymond. She played the mom, Marie, on the show. She died over the weekend of natural causes. She was 90.
You want some real marriage advice? I'm going to give you the secret now. There's going to be yelling. There's going to be anger. Don't fight it. Accept it. You love him. You hate him. He disgusts you. Look how he eats. You keep your head down and you plow through.
Amen.
I can't believe she was 90.
Yeah.
I mean, I just saw her interviewed on TMZ not too long ago, out with her boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
She looked great.
She's from St. Louis.
Is she?
Yes. You didn't mention that. You didn't know that.
No, I did. I forgot.
I didn't know that.
We talked about it earlier this morning from St. Louis. Ray Romano said, she had an energy and spirit that amazed me. She never stopped. She was nurturing and she was great mentoring a young green comic trying to make it as an actor. She did it all with such a grand love for life and people that I will miss her dearly. Joe Manganiello, Sophia, let's say Mr. Vergara, now that he's married to Sophia Vergara, because everybody seems to butcher his last name. I'm included in that. He recently dropped out of this History Channel job. And they said it was a recurring
the SEAL team deal.
They say he couldn't do it because of a health problem. We didn't know. And then Sunday he was supposed to be at a charity event in Hollywood. He was a no-show. Mm. Pretty serious. He checked in the hospital late last week to have his appendix removed, and there were complications during the surgery. His appendix burst. Can be deadly if it's not treated right away. But he was already in surgery.
Poisoned the peritoneal cavity.
So we haven't.
I went to Wash U Mini Med School.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people believe, even though they haven't gotten any updates, that he's still in the hospital. So we hope he's doing well. Golden Globes changing their rules. The Hollywood Foreign Press announced a bunch of rule changes. The biggest one is thanks to Matt Damon. The Martian, if you remember, was nominated in the Best Comedy category.
That's right,
yep. So they have Best Drama, bunch of nominees there, and then they have Best Comedy or Musical. And everyone is scratching their heads about, my head actually itches. they're scratching their heads about The Martian as Best Comedy. Like, it wasn't funny, haha.
Well, and they always have weird categories for television, too.
Yeah.
Like,
miniseries.
Yeah. And it's a show that's on every single year.
Yeah.
Yeah. So because not only did The Martian get nominated, but it won in Best Comedy.
And it kind of ruins it for real authentic comedy.
Right.
Yeah. And Birdman also was nominated as a comedy back in 2014. So they didn't really elaborate on the new rules, but they're doing it to make sure that it doesn't happen again and so that comedies won't slip into drama.
Yeah, it's not fair.
They're making sure the dramas with comedic undertones still end up in the best drama category.
Yeah. Yes.
It's got to be funny, haha.
Right. I mean, because you have a train wreck that could have won.
Right.
Right.
If you took The Martian out of it, though, I think the next two that were vying for it were The Big Short and
not funny. Can't remember the other one.
Something else that wasn't that funny. I mean, Trainwreck was probably the only legitimate comedy. Speaking of the Golden Globes, a big winner in all of the awards this past year, The Revenant with Leonardo DiCaprio out on DVD. Make sure to have your chapstick handy because you're going to want to His lips are just not good in the film.
That's called frostbite.
The Lady in the Van, Norm of the North for the kids is out, and 50 Shades of Black, the 50 Shades of Grey parody with Marlon Wayans. And on TV tonight, the season finale of Brooklyn Nine-Nine, new series Containment on the CW, and the premiere of The Night Manager on AMC with Tom Hiddleston. That is Entertainment Schmig. More at 8:40 and online at Y98.com.